Hello everyone, and once again welcome to my channel Engineering Made Simple. Now in the last lecture we studied binary arithmetic. This is the part 2 of the same lecture. Now in today's lecture we will study something called as complements. So till now we studied four number systems, that is binary number system, octal number system, hexadecimal number system. At some points about decimal number systems also we studied, so that is the fourth one. So there are different types of complements available, namely 1's complement, 2's complement, 15's complement, 7's complement, 8's complement, and so on. And they are available in those different number systems. Now what is a complement? Complement technique is a technique used in digital computers or digital systems or any digital systems that are used to convert a subtraction problem into an addition problem. That is, simply if I want to put it in words, then complements are the things that are used to simplify operations, simplify subtraction operations in various digital devices, namely digital computer and digital subtraction. Because as you know, addition is always simpler than division. Now we saw examples related to subtraction as well. In binary arithmetic part 1 of the lecture, we saw subtraction of two binary numbers. But if the binary number is too large, then it is difficult to compute the subtraction. Then every time we have to remember from which bit borrow we have taken, and then we have to subtract the borrow, and then final result is obtained. So whenever you convert an addition subtraction problem into an addition one, the cumbersome process of remembering the borrow and then every time we have to subtract it reduces. So we make use of this complement system. Now let's start studying the first two main important complements, that is 1's and 2's complement. So 1's and 2's complements are available in binary number system. Now let us study the first type of complements in this course, that is 1's complement and 2's complement, which are used in binary number system. So let us take an example. Suppose thing you have a number 1101 and you have been asked to calculate its 1's complement first. Then what you will do, subtract every bit of the number by 1. So this is 1101, this is 4 bit representation. So there will be 4 1's and you will subtract each bit of that number using 4 1's. So this is how we obtain 1's complement. So the given number is 1101 in this case, right? So 1 minus 1 is 0, 1 minus 0 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, and 1 minus 1 will be again 0. So this is how we obtain 1's complement of a number. So this is 1's complement. But there exists another simple way to compute 1's complement. Now suppose think this number, I have this number, same number I am taking, 1101, and I want to compute its 1's complement. Then how I will do? I will simply invert the bits. Wherever there is 1 present, I will replace it with 0, and wherever there is 0 present, I will replace it with 1. So let's see, using simpler technique. So 1101. Now wherever you have 1, you have to replace with 0. So then here we have 1101, so 0010. So as you can see, by both the techniques answer is same. So this is how you compute 1's complement. So 1's complement is pretty easy. Now we move on to the 2's complement of a number. We will take the same example. Now we are computing 2's complement. Two's complement of a number. So 1101 was the number, right? Then we have to compute 2's complement. Now how will you do that? 2's complement is defined as, 2's complement of a number is defined as 1's complement plus 1. Now how will you compute 1's complement you studied earlier? So what was the 1's complement of that number? 0010. Replace every 1 by 0 and 0 by 1. So that is first complement. then add 1 to it. So what will be your answer in 2's complement form? That is 0, 0, 1, 1. Because you simply add 1. So this is nothing but 2's complement. Now, why I am taking this topic is that questions are asked on basis of 2's complement and 1's complement, addition or subtraction. Mainly subtraction is asked, so I am going to cover only subtraction over here. So in order to do that, first you should be able to compute the different complements which are available in number system. So 2's complement is pretty much simpler. It is simple that 1's complement plus 1, if you add to that number, you will get 2's complement. So 2's complement is nothing but 1's complement plus 1. And there is one simpler method to compute 2's complement as well. So you have, this is the LSB bit, this is the MSB bit, right? So you have to keep, while computing 2's complement, you have to keep the bits as it is till you encounter the first one. First one in that number which you want to compute is 2 complement. So first bit, till the first bit, suppose 1 is here, then you will copy down it as it is. So this one in the LSB will copy down as it is and invert the rest of the bit. Here 0 is there, so 1, then again 0, 0. So remember this shortcut, that even if you have a number, let's say 1, 1, 1, 0, and you have to find its 2's complement, then copy down these two digits as it is, till the first one of the number starting from LSB. So this will be 0, 1, and then again this will be 0, 0. So you will get directly 2's complement of a number. So I hope this is pretty much clear. Till the first one encounters from LSB, copy the same number as it is and then rest bits you invert. Wherever 1 is there, then you will put 0, 0 is there, you will put 1. So this is nothing but 2's complement. Now we will move on to the 9's and 10's complement. Nines and tens complement of a number. So from the name itself, it suggests that these complements are available in decimal number system. Decimal number system is the system which we use in our day-to-day lives. So decimal number system. So now suppose thing I have a number, let's say 2, 4, 9, 6 in decimal number system, and I have been asked to compute its 9's complement. Let's say, and how will I compute? Now any complement, you know, this is 9's complement and this is 4 bit decimal number, so you will put 4 times 9 and then you will subtract 2, 4, 9, 6, and as you know it is decimal number system, it is very easy for us. So 9 minus 6 will be 3, 9 minus 9 is 0, 9 minus 4 is 5, 9 minus 2 is 7. So 7503 to the base 10 is the 9's complement. Now once you know 9's complement, if anybody asks you, find the 10's complement of the same number, then what you will do? You have answer of 9's complement, right? That is 7503. Now you want to compute 10's complement of 2, 4, 9, 6. So what is 10's complement? It will be 9's complement plus 1. So here it will be 7503, which is the 9's complement of 2, 4, 9, 6. Plus 1, then what will be your answer for 10's complement? 7504 to the base 10. This is 10's complement. This is 10's complement of 2, 4, 9, 6. So now the third type of complement which we are going to study is 8's and 9's complement. So from this name only we will come to know that it is a part of octave number system. That is, we can obtain 8's and 9's complement of a number when the number is in octave number system. So let us write an octave number, and we will first find, sorry, it's not 8's and 9's complement, it is 7's and 8's complement. 7's and 8's complement. So from the name only we will come to know that it is an octave number system. So let's say we have been given a number, let's say it is 5, 6, 8 to the base 8. This 8 indicates that this is a number in octave number system. Now we want to find first its 7's complement. Now in order to find its 7's complement, as it is a 3 bit number, 777 minus 5, 6, 8. So 7 minus, so here 9, 0, 2. Okay. So it is pretty much similar to earlier complement, just in 7's complement we subtracted the given number by 7, each digit of the number by 7. So we get this answer. So this is nothing but 7's complement. Now if somebody asks you 8's complement of the number, same number, then what you will do? 7's complement plus 1. So 8's complement of a number is nothing but 7's complement plus 1. So you have this answer of 7's complement. We will write it over here. 209 to the base 8 plus 1. So now we will study 7's and 8's complement. So from its name only it is clear that it is a part of octave number system. That is, any number given, if you want to compute 7's and 8's complement of a number, then it should be given in octave number system. Now let us say, for example, you have a number 562 and you want to compute its 7's complement. So you want to compute its 7's complement, so simply you have to subtract every bit of the given number from 7. So it is pretty much clear. I have written, as this is a 3 bit number, I have written 7 3 times, and then we are subtracting each bit. After subtraction we get 215, which is an octal number. So this is nothing but 7's complement of that number. And if somebody asks you to compute 8's complement of the number, what you will do, simply add 1 to the 7's complement of the number. So 8's complement is nothing but 7's complement plus 1. Then you will get the answer as 216 in octal number system. Now the next type of complements which we are going to learn are 15's and 16's complement. So the next type, that is fourth type of complement, is 15's and 16's complement. Okay. Now let us start by studying 15's complement. Okay. Now from the name only, 15's and 16's. So you should know that the number should be in hexadecimal number system in order to compute its 15th or 16th complement. Now let's take an example. You have hexadecimal number, let's say 3BF is to the base 16 or H. This is a number given in hexadecimal system. Now what we are supposed to do? Find its 15th complement. Now how we will do that? So what is hexadecimal equivalent of 15 over here? Because we are doing it in hexadecimal number system, so the subtraction should be also in hexadecimal number system. So that's the reason we are subtracting every bit of that number by f. F is hexadecimal equivalent of 15. So this is the decimal equivalent and this is the hexadecimal equivalent. Okay. Then we subtract the given number 3BF. So let's start doing. F minus F is 0. Okay. F minus B is 4. F minus 3 is C. So this is the 15th complement. Okay. And if I want to compute 16th complement, then what I will do, I will simply add 1 to this number in order to get 16th complement. That is 15th complement will plus 1 will give you 16th complement. So answer will be C41 to the base 16. So this is how you compute 15 and 16th complement in hexadecimal number system. Now regarding this subtraction, there is a small trick in order to do hexadecimal subtraction. I will explain to you. So as hexadecimal subtraction is slightly different from our normal binary or decimal subtraction, we have to keep this thing in mind. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F. So as you can see, the numbers in somewhat circle, it is not necessarily a circle. I arrange it in a circular fashion somewhat. Numbers from 0 to F. So F is present and A is also present, then you understand that the numbers are hexadecimal. Now let's say we have the earlier example only, 3BF. Okay. And for 15th complement, what did we subtract? We subtract every bit from this number, right? 3BF. And then we perform subtraction. But now, first subtraction in this case was very much similar. So F minus F is 0. So it was pretty much clear. Now the next one, F minus B. Now, how will you subtract F minus B? You will count every digit from here. You have to subtract F minus B, that is you have to subtract B from F. So you will compute every bit over here. So how will you get 4, that I will tell you. So you have to count till B. So this is 1 from F, okay? Right from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 means A and then B. So where does B coincide to 4? That's why F minus B is 4. Similarly for F minus B, I have to do the same thing. So from F, count till 3. So first one will come over here, 2, 3, then C will be there. So this is a simpler technique in which you will be able to perform hexadecimal subtraction. Now till now we have studied all the different types of complements available in different number systems. Now we will study its utility or uses in subtraction, primarily binary subtraction, because binary subtraction using 2's complement and 1's complement are usually asked in your university exam or any competitive exam as well. So we will directly move on to that topic. Using 1's complement. Now let's say, but before moving on to subtraction using 1's complement, there is a simple topic which I want to make it clear in order to have better understanding of subtraction using 1's complement, 2's complement method, is that signed and unsigned numbers. just in case of our decimal number in our day to day life. So if I write minus 10 to the base 10, then many of you can plot it on the number scale and tell me, because you are studying this from 5th standard, that where is minus 10 located on your number system scale. But in digital electronics also, we have something called as positive and negative. But as I told you earlier, we use binary and hexadecimal number system in your digital system. Now, how will you come to know whether the number is positive or negative? Because it is not in decimal number system. So for that one, let's say I have an example over here. And what is meaning of signed and unsigned? Unsigned numbers means meaning the numbers which are binary or hexadecimal or octal, which do not have any sign. The numbers which don't have any sign are known as unsigned number. And signs are the ones which have a particular sign. Now, how will you represent sign in case of these digits? First technique is sign bit magnitude. Now, let's say if I have a number, let's say decimal number 2. And then I have to represent decimal number 2 in binary, that is 0010. Let's take 4 bit representation. Okay, so this is, we will study sign bit magnitude. Now, this is a decimal number. I have converted it into equivalent binary number. Then, how will you identify or put a sign to it? Now, currently this is an unsigned number because I have not mentioned any sign over here. In decimal representation also, neither in the binary representation. So, this is an unsigned number. But suppose thing I want to put a sign over here. Suppose thing if I write plus 2 to the base 10. Now, how will I represent this plus in binary digits? 0, 0, 1, 0. Then this is the MSB bit, okay? This is the LSB bit. Now remember one thing, in sign bit magnitude form, your MSB bit represents the sign. Now here it is 0 is given. So what is this MSB bit represents sign. So 0 means positive, and 1 means negative number in sign bit magnitude. Okay. In sign bit magnitude form, MSB is 0, then the number is positive. MSB is 1, then number is negative. So this is how we interpret signs in case of binary or hexadecimal or octal. So if then the MSB bit is 0, then it is positive. MSB bit is 1, then it is negative. So if I want to write minus 2. Now, if I want to write minus 2. Let's see. The representation will be same, only MSB bit will be replaced by 1. This only represents the sign. Okay. So why it is called as sign bit magnitude? One bit represents the sign and other represents the magnitude of the number. So what is exactly the number? The magnitude. That is the positive part of the answer or the magnitude of that number is represented by this magnitude part. And MSB bit represents the sign part, okay? So this is signed and unsigned numbers. Now let us move on to subtraction using ones complement. We will perform subtraction of unsigned numbers. Signed ones are pretty much easy if you understand this procedure. Now I will start explaining subtraction using ones complement. So what is this? Supposing I want to subtract some number A minus B using 1's complement. Then what I will do? I will take the 1's complement of B, then add it to A. As I told you earlier, complements technique is used to convert subtraction problem into an addition problem. Now if the result of addition A plus B's 1's complement, some end carry generated from the carry generated, then add the carry back to the result. In such a case, we say that the answer is positive when you use 1's complement arithmetic. So if an end around carry or carry generated from the last bit, then we say that whenever end around carry generated, we say that answer is positive. answer of the subtraction is positive. Then if no carry is generated, then answer is negative in 1's complement form. The answer which we get is in 1's complement form. Now whenever no carry is generated, then answer is negative and it is in 1's complement form. And if you want to get back in the true form, that is not in 1's complement form, you have to simply invert the bits of the final result, just as in the case when the result is negative. So by taking an example, this would be pretty much clear. Now I will take example only on signed numbers are pretty much simpler. Only thing you have to look after the sign bit. Now I have told you earlier, how will you represent sign bit of that particular number? Now let's see, if you have a number, if you want to subtract 9, okay, minus 4 in 2's complement, 1's complement, sorry. Now we want to perform the subtraction, but it is not normal subtraction. We have to perform it using 1's complement. As it is told in 1's complement, we will have to write its equivalent binary representation, because 1's and 2's complement is present only in binary numbers. So how will you represent a 9 over here? So 1001 is a 9. How will you represent a 4? But this 4, I will write its binary representation over here in 4 bit, 0100 in binary. But now what I told you in the algorithm earlier, that we have to find the first complement of the number which you want to subtract and then add it. Now 1's complement of this number, that is 4, because we want to convert subtraction into addition. While doing subtraction using 1's complement, let this part be very much clear. Now 4 is represented this way. Now 1's complement meaning wherever 0 is present, replace it by 1. And wherever 1 is present, replace it by 0. Okay, so we are performing subtraction only, but as it is in 1's complement, it is in addition form. So how will you add now? 1 plus 1, 0. Carry will be generated. 1 plus 1, carry will be generated. 1. And then 1 plus 1, sum is 0 and carry will be 1. So this carry is generated. When carry is generated, we say that answer is positive while doing 1's complement arithmetic. Now tell me one thing, as the number from which we have subtraction is bigger than another number, suppose thing if we do 9 minus 4 in decimal number system, answer will be positive only, answer will be 5. So when you are converting it into binary and subtracting, your answer will be positive. So this is a way to check it as well. So carry is generated over here. Now what we are supposed to do with that carry? Add with that result. So what you will get? 0101. Now what is the decimal equivalent of 0101? It is 5. So our answer is correct. 9 minus 4 in decimal number system, if we compute, then we get 5. And then binary equivalent using binary numbers and subtraction using 1's complement, also we get the same number. So we write answer is positive using 1's complement arithmetic. Answer is positive as n around carry is generated over here. And it is in true form because it is a number, so it is not in 1's complement form. It is the actual number. It is not in 1's complement form. So answer is positive. Let's say I will write the statement over here. I will write it here. I have to write it at the bottom. Answer is positive after the subtraction and it is in true form. It is in the form in which we would like to represent. Because remember, we took only 1's complement of that number because we wanted to convert subtraction problem into an addition problem. So complements are basically used to simplify operations, but we want the answer back in actual or true form only. In case if it is positive, then it is simpler. Now let us invert the same example. Now let us see what happens when we get a negative number. many people in ones complement form. Now question remains the same, only we will invert position. So subtraction using ones complement. Now we subtracted 9 minus 4, right? Instead we will subtract 4 minus 9. Procedure will be similar again. What is the binary representation of 4? 0, 1, 0, 0. Now take the 1's complement of 9's binary representation. This is the binary representation for 9. Okay. How will you represent the same thing using 1's complement? So here it will be 0, 1, 1, 0. And we have to add it, okay? 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0. So as you can see here, no carry is generated from this addition operation. So whenever no carry is generated, no carry is generated and answer is negative in this case. As you can see, sign MSB bit is 1. So this bit represents sign. So this 1010 is nothing but whatever you are getting is minus 5 in decimal. So this is also minus because this sign bit is 1. But now we want the answer in our actual form. This is in 1's complement form. So many of you will get confused. So because 1010 is not 5, binary equivalent for 5. But if you want in true form, the answer in true form, then you will invert. That this is in 1's complement form, okay? Because we took 1's complement and then added the number and then carry was not generated, that's why it was negative and in 1's complement form. The supposed thing we want to find the answer in true form, not in 1's complement. So if somebody asks you, keep it in 1's complement form only when the answer is negative, then it is fine, you will stop at this step because you have got the answer in 1's complement form. But if you want the answer in true form or the actual form, what you will do, simply take 1's complement of that number. Sorry, I'll write it over here. So whatever result you have obtained is negative, right? In 1's complement form. So this answer is in 1's complement form, I have to find its true form. So what I will do for finding its true form, take the 1's complement of that number again. Or simply invert the bits. Now here 1 is there, so here 0 will be there. Here 1 will be there. Here 0 will be there. And see the magic. Again I have got the answer as 5. But you know the answer was negative. So while writing, you will write. It is answer is 5 in true form. But sign bit generated will be negative only. Because this is an answer in true form. But we are subtracting a small larger number from smaller number. So by rules of normal mathematics, answer will be negative. And this will be in true form. And the earlier answer was also negative, but in 1's complement form. Now similar procedure you can do when signed numbers are also given. So signed numbers I am not going to do. We will move on to subtraction using 2's complement. But if you have any doubts or you want some examples related to signed numbers using 1's and 2's complement, you can write it in the comment section of YouTube so that I can consider taking it as well. Now subtraction using 2's complement. So now we will study subtraction of 2 numbers using 2's complement form. I hope 1's complement was pretty much clear. Now we have 2 numbers, supposing say A and B. Now we want to subtract these 2 numbers using 2's complement arithmetic. Then what we will do? We are subtracting B from A, right? So we will take 2's complement now instead of 1's complement of B and then add it to A. If carry is generated in this case, then your answer is positive and it is in the actual form, not the 2's complement. And then you have to simply ignore the carry and write the final answer, which is positive. if carry is generated, then answer is positive. Supposing another case, the else case for this one. If carry is not generated, then we say that answer is negative in the 2's complement form. That is, the answer which is obtained will be in the 2's complement form. But if you want the answer in actual form or true form, then what you will do, the take the number or the result which is in 2's complement form, and then again find its 2's complement of that number, or the answer of subtraction whose result is negative. Take the 2's complement of that number again to get the answer in true form or the actual form. This will be pretty much clear when we take the example like the earlier case. Take the same thing, same example. So we were doing same examples for 9 minus 4, but this time using 2's complement arithmetic. So first step, binary equivalent of 9 is 1001, binary equivalent of 4 is 0100. But what we have to do over here, 2's complement subtraction using 2's complement, right? So we are going to subtract 4 from 9. That's the reason we are going to take 2's complement of this number. So see, 0011. So this is the 2's complement of the 4, and then we add this 2, 1001 plus 1100, which is the 2's complement of 4. Remember, 1010, carry is generated. That's the reason. Now answer is positive, and it is in the true form. But in this case, we ignore the carry. We during 2's complement and write the answer, which is in true form, which is 0101, which is nothing but a positive number because 0 is present over here in binary number system. And if we convert it into decimal, answer will be positive 5. So it is pretty much clear. The answer is same only, 9 minus 4, 5. Just in this case, we use 2's complement arithmetic. Now we will see the reverse case when we subtract the larger number from the smaller number. What will we do? Now the question is similar, but it is reversed. Now we have to subtract two numbers, that is 4 minus 9 in 2's complement form. We have to subtract larger number from smaller number. So by common sense only you can tell, or by knowledge of normal mathematics, your answer is going to be negative in this case. Because you are subtracting a larger number, which is 9 from 4. But we will have to perform it using 2's complement arithmetic. So let's take binary equivalent. Binary equivalent of 4 is 0100. Binary equivalent of 9 is 1001. Okay. And from here, we are subtracting 9. So we have to take its 2's complement. So this is 9's 2 complement, that is 0112. Now we have to add these two. 0100 plus 2's complement of 9. What is it? 0111. So this is the answer you are getting, 1011. But answer is negative as no carry is generated. No carry generated. Okay. So answer is negative. Answer is negative. So this is negative only. So this is 1011. But what this is actually? Minus 5. But we don't want answer in 2's complement form, right? this is in 2's complement form, but we want to answer in actual or true form. Then what we can do for that? For answer in true form, let's see, we will again take 2's complement of result. Complement of result of subtraction. 2's complement of result which we obtain. As no carry generated, answer is negative and it is in 2's complement form. Now we want to find the answer in actual form. So for that what we will do, again we will take 2's complement of 1101. So what will be its 2's complement? Simply place 1 over here, 0, 1. So see, 2's complement of that number will give you 0101, which is nothing but binary equivalent for 5. But remember, we are subtracting larger number from a smaller number. So while writing, you will write, this is the true form, but actual answer is minus 5 only. So these are the two main topics from this lecture, which are asked in your university exams or competitive exams as well. Subtraction using 1's complement and subtractions using 2's complement. So I hope this topic was pretty much clear. With this 2's complement arithmetic, we come towards the end of the binary arithmetic topic or the part 2 of the lecture. Now last but not the least, if you like this video, please do like, share and subscribe my channel, and don't forget to hit the bell icon for the notification of my latest uploads. Thank you.